Pre-merge bandit, there's Dazed. I'm diving to try to get a low lead turn on him. But he is going to react to this by trying to get beneath me. When I recognize that he's doing that, I'm going to cut right to create horizontal turning room as well as vertical. There he goes. I go right, create the horizontal turning room. Pick him back up, roll the vector in front, and pull. And I pull too hard and black out. This is a mistake that's going to give him an advantage in the lead turn. And he is able to convert to my rear hemisphere and now has offensive position on me. So at this point, I've got to decide what to do. I'm in a high speed, nose low extension. Okay, I'm going to slow the fight down so that we can have a little bit more time to see what's happening. I'm in a nose low right turn extending. He doesn't have closure, so no, we're basically at the same speed. So I'm going to initiate a right turn, a brake turn, but slowly building the G's to maximum while I bring him to my lift vector. Basically, I want him to arrive at my lift vector just as I pull maximum G. This will create the maximum potential for an overshoot. There he is approaching the lift vector. I've learned a lot about the bandit in my building G right turn. He did not immediately go to pull lead to try for a high angle snapshot. So he's a smart bandit. He used lag pursuit to try to achieve my turn circle. I know we're at approximately the same speed because the closure rate is not great. And I also know we're at approximately the same G level because he's attempting to match my turn circle. At this point in the fight, I have two choices. I could roll wings level and attempt a nose low extension and try to open up the range beyond guns range again and either exit the fight or try again. Or I can try to convert this into a rolling scissors fight and beat him with technique. The reason I say beat him with technique, because the way you win a rolling scissors fight is either through superior performance of the aircraft or through superior technique. We're in the same aircraft at the same fuel load, so the only thing that will win this high G rolling scissors for me is going to be superior technique. So what I'm going to do is hold him on the lift vector and watch what happens. And as soon as I see him sliding aft into lag, his velocity vector will be in lag pursuit once he starts sliding aft. I'm going to roll wings level, do a hard G pitch up, roll left, put the lift vector in lead pursuit, slight lead pursuit on the bandit, and do a high G barrel roll holding that lift vector in lead pursuit on the bandit. And this is going to cause an overshoot of the bandit as we barrel roll around in a rolling scissors. The video will start. It'll be at half speed for clarity. There's the bandit. I'm pulling hard. He's starting to drift behind. I see him. There he is. Velocity vector in lag pursuit. This is the point where I'm going to start my roll to level and a hard pull up. And we're at a very high G level, so this is all going to happen fairly slowly. All the way to blackout. I pick him back up. I'm pulling as hard as I can, trying to get that lift vector back on him in lead pursuit. There you see me adjusted. Lift vector and lead and pull, lift vector and lead and pull, and I keep adjusting as I go around, rolling that lift vector to slight lead and pull, all the way into blackout, but I know he's got to be there. Remember, this is half speed, so it's happening kind of slow. Keep doing this, and eventually I've got him in the front quarter, roll, lift vector and lead and pull. Keep on doing the same technique over and over again. He's breaking back in. I'm going to roll. You have to imagine my lift vector is in lead, way deep lead, pulling, and he's all in the front quarter view now, and he is pretty much in a defensive position. And now I'm firmly saddled up in his rear hemisphere. And he's defensive. And that's how you convert with a rolling scissors conversion. Lag roll reversal, rolling scissors. And we'll see the rest of the film, we'll see the fight over again at normal speed. There we go. Pre-merge. Pitch the nose down, going for the bottom position for the vertical lead turn. He wants to do the same thing. As soon as I recognize that's what he's doing, I'm going to offset to the right to create horizontal turning room. I make a mistake on my lead turn and black out. I have to relax the G so I can see again. And that's all he needs to gain the offensive position. I know I've made the mistake, so I'm going to relax the G and extend away. And then I decide I'm going to re-enter the fight with a building G right turn to bring the bandit to the lift vector, just as he gets to guns range. If he pulled hard lead and was going for the gunshot, I would get skinny just as the tracer started to fly and get a much better overshoot, but he's a smart bandit. He's trying to get to my turn circle, so I need to do a lag roll reversal and convert via rolling scissors. So there's my lag roll reversal, nose high, lift vector, lead pursuit, lift vector, lead pursuit, pull, lift vector, lead pursuit, pull, lift vector, lead pursuit, pull. All the way back around, he's transitioning front quarter, lift vector, lead pursuit, pull. Now he's going to be all front quarter, but still, roll the lift vector into lead pursuit. It's imagining it now, I'm not actually looking that way. Oh, I took a glance, didn't I? Lift vector, lead pursuit, pull, and I've converted him to a defensive position. And at this point, my technique, using the lift vector to lead pursuit and pull, and he's not doing it, has degraded his energy state such that he is now at a stall, and I actually just disengaged from the fight because he was having trouble controlling the aircraft at this point. And that is all there is to that.